What is up, guys? This is Josh Boost Creations once again. Today we are having another video on that carburetor, the Edelbrock that was being rebuilt. If you've been following the Instagram page, you know it is about time to be getting it rebuilt. Got some last minute stuff I need to go through and kind of scrub off and try to get cleaned out the best I can, but it is about ready to go together. Excuse me. But it is about ready to go back together. Like I said, there's just some last minute stuff I need to scrape off, and I'll kind of go over all that as I rebuild it. But it is ready to go together. I've got it on this little makeshift table here. Little styrofoam, like body board or whatever they want to call it. But I am about to get started on it, and I'm going to take you with me. So stay tuned. All right, so I pretty much have everything laid out. If you saw the previous video, this was pretty much all rust colored. There was a couple of spots I couldn't quite reach that was in this accelerator pump area here, and then I didn't even try to get that jet out anymore, just for the fact of all I was doing was shearing it off. There are pieces that you'll get in the rebuild kit that you're pretty much gonna be replacing. Like, you're gonna be replacing these, the screens, the actual, you know, valve here. It's not really a valve, but it's just kind of like your fuel comes through it. This is what actually limits your fuel. So I mean, you can just get a carburetor rebuilding kit, 1477. Works for all Performer and I think Thunder AVS series carburetors. Pretty sure I have a Performer here that is not very performing very well at the moment. But hopefully once I get all this put together, get it back together and get it running right, it would be a different story. But I'm gonna start with the last minute cleaning. I got some like eyeglass screwdrivers here, just trying to scratch this last little bit of rust off. Alright, well, we got that as clean as we're possibly going to get it for now. This carburetor doesn't have to run perfect, but getting as much of it cleaned up as I can will definitely help later down the road, because it will be more for the street side of things, and less likely to be used for performance. It'd be something I'll take off, or take the quick fuel off once I get one, and use it as just the street carburetor. But as for now, I can go ahead and start taking stuff out of the wrapper. Like I said before, it does come with new pieces here, and it's got the push-in screens with the new washer. The only thing you'll notice is this one has like the almost like a clip-on style. So I will have to use my old ones and just make sure that they're the same size. Because this is the type that you would like clip onto a float and it would stay with the float, but obviously I don't have that kind, so I have to reuse mine. Just gonna compare them real quick, make sure that they are the same size. I'm also gonna make sure that it goes in this smoothly, doesn't hang on anything, because it's the last thing I need is to hang on this and either not let fuel in or... Alright, well, it moves smoothly. Doesn't hang. It's got a 42 engraved on it. This one doesn't have anything engraved on it. But, see, it is just a pull-out screen. So, I'm going to take the new screen. Go ahead and just rip this bag open. And hopefully not spill it. Alright, we're gonna take the screen. We're just going to push it in here. Alright, something you'll notice on the rebuild kits, you do get these with the screens here. And you also get the screen that's meant to go in this piece right here. you don't use both this screen and this screen. I don't know why, just it's very clear in the directions not to. But we're going to go ahead and assemble that one, get the other one, and it does come with a piece for rebuilding like a manual choke, or an electric choke rather. I don't need this. I do need some pieces out of it though. It comes with a new like accelerator pump, check ball, and weight, which I do need out of this. And I do want this because I'm going to be blocking off some of the vacuum stuff to this carburetor. So I'm going to open this, steal what I need, and call it quits. So there's the weight. I feel like I'm playing one of those little games. You got to try to get the hole, the little ball in the hole. All right, so the check ball, pretty simply put, goes right there. And you just put the weight in there. And then when you go to put all of it back together, voila. This is it's like a choke gasket. We don't have an electric choke here. It's a manual choke. So we're not too worried about that. You get some of these gaskets out of the way here. All right, here's that other piece. Go ahead and assemble it real fast. Just want the screen. All right, so I got the screen. I'm gonna get it in there. Hopefully. They can be a pain sometimes. Just gotta be a little patient. On a flashing light over there, saw it in the corner of my eyes, bothering me. And eventually the patience will wear thin. All right, well, I just bent mine. So this is what you don't want to do. So in this case, I'm going to dump those and I will go back to the other style one, which, like I said, does come with it. It's this style that goes up in here. I'm gonna actually run it like this. So pretty much you'd kind of keep it like that and it'll tighten itself up against it. So I do wanna do some last minute cleaning on this and through here. So it's not gonna be quite put together like that yet. Get this washer here. Alright, so I don't need anything else in that bag. Put this washer right here. And get this other washer. Set it off to the side. Alright, so these are the old pieces. And like I said, I can't use these. So I'm going to use these spring-loaded ones that came that were written originally. So that means I have to for sure make sure I keep up with this and this little spring, because that little spring does go in here. Keeps it spring-loaded. So you do have to make sure to check float level with that instead of this hard one. I could probably use this hard one. Actually, yeah, I'll use this hard one. That way I have a dedicated float level. And I do have this piece, which pretty sure takes the ball check valve and the ball takes point of that. So I'm going to be replacing that. It doesn't come with new jets, unfortunately. So, I mean, the best way is kind of look through them, make sure they're clean. These ones have been cleaned up a little bit. They're not perfect, but they're definitely better than what they were. All right, so part of the rebuild kit, which, like I said, I'm surprised it doesn't come with some of the springs and stuff already assembled. I'm gonna take this one out since I'm not using it. Throw it to the side there out of anger. Keep these here. And one way to upgrade this to make it run a little richer is you have these needles here. And the spring goes in a little cup here. Basically, as you have more vacuum, it sucks this needle down and causes it to lean it out. Because as you can see, the needle does get thicker as it goes up, and it's in stages. Like, it's tapered here, and then just there's a hard point here where it gets bigger. The further down this needle goes, the less fuel you get in. So a way to upgrade it to run a little richer is to get a beefier spring, which does not come with this kit. Kind of surprised, because this is kind of a wear item in my opinion. Or you can stretch the spring out a little bit. Now, stretching the spring out, it will raise the spring up a little bit and give you a little bit more pressure, but it's not a guaranteed way because there are two different ones. So you'd have to have them perfectly matching, which let me compare these side by side. As far as length, they look the same, but spring pressure, they could be just a little bit different. So I don't advise doing that method. I would just advise trying to find like a jetting kit. You know, Edelbrock does offer a jetting kit, so you can do something like that. Now for one of the harder parts, getting these jets back in without messing them up. All right, so I do want a clean screwdriver that still fits in there good. Found one. And like I said, it is kind of a trick because they are in the middle of nowhere. All right, so you kind of get it in there. Put your screwdriver in there, use it to balance it out. I always turn it counterclockwise till I feel the pop. And then that's how I know that it's actually started in the revs. And you don't want them super tight, but you do want to bottom it out. Give it a quick tap. All right, the back one's not gonna be that bad since it's right there. Just kind of place it in there. So you could hear it going in. So then you just screw it back in. Nice and snug. This one, like I said, it's a pain. Alright. So I originally missed it because I hit the carburetor at the screwdriver. Alright, so it's snug. So the jets are in. They are 120s. They all are 120s. Not 100% sure which ones or what it comes with from the factory, but that is what is in mine, so that's what I'm gonna run for now. Let's see here. Oh, and it also comes with accelerator pump goodies. So we're gonna have to get into our old parts here. And I think I put the accelerator pump off to the side. Got those. Yeah, it's right here. I need these here in a second too. All right, so got the accelerator pump, and it does come with a new piece here because, as you can see, you stretch it out and kind of holds its shape for a minute. So you do need to put the new one on it. All right, so I got the accelerator pump apart. It's not like you don't take the whole thing apart, like I was for some reason thinking. So I was kind of thinking that that one went on it, but the spring does it, would not make very much sense. You just kind of pull it off, but once you get it all off, you can kind of see that the one that comes with it has a lot more life to it, whereas this one's kind of hard and crusty. So you just want to kind of get it over that first notch here. and work it on around, and there you go. So I guess the new accelerator pump ought to do a lot better as far as shoving some fuel through there. But all right, let's get started here. So that does not go here. Just kidding, it really does go there. But you want to compare it to the old one and make sure that it's somewhat similar. It does look a little bigger. So I mean, I could technically run a dual spring, but that would kind of fight it from pumping. And we don't want that. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put that in there, shove it down. And then we're just going to put this in there, but we're not gonna shove it down or anything yet. All right, I'm gonna put these springs back on the idle air screws because I feel like I'm going to lose them if I don't. And I will go ahead and start them. And then the idle air screws, I normally ran mine all the way in. And then you don't want to force it. You just want to screw them in till they stop. Stopped. And then 1.5 turns. That's a starting point. Like, that at least gets you running and then lets you figure it out from there. So it stopped, half, one, half. All right, so a lot of other screws are in. Now we want to, I do want to do some last minute cleanup on this, and I need to recenter this carburetor because my makeshift desk is kind of rough. But I gotta figure out something I can get in here to actually brush it out. I thought I had some brushes here, but apparently I do not. So I'm gonna find something to clean this out real fast, and I'll be right back. All right, well, I couldn't find anything to actually clean it out very well with, so I kind of just used the same screwdriver to reach what I could. So obviously, I do need to find something for this later, because only get it in right there, which means it only makes it about almost half the way through. So I kind of scratched around a little bit, and through all that work, got quite a bit of gunk out. So even though I know it's going to cause problems later on the road, I'm going to go ahead and put it back together and run it as is, because I'm not a professional rebuilder. I don't have the proper tools to get actually down there. So you just want to make sure, if you're doing this yourself, you get a long brush, preferably something that's a little aggressive, that way you can actually scratch it off, because it's basically just like scaled up rust and aluminum mixed with fuel. It's kind of baked down on there. But I mean, just do it the best you can, get it cleaned out, because all that does flush right into those bowls here, and as you saw earlier in the previous video, it can cause issues. So we're gonna go ahead and put all this together, and we wanna make sure we put these new washers on. Personally, I don't know which way they want you to put it on, but I put the shiny side up. You do have to kind of thread it on for some reason. I don't know why they make them that tight, but thread it on and at least get it started. Maybe. It doesn't help that little shield's in the way. All right. I'm not mentally unstable. I'm just tired. All right, so that got that one started. Grab this other one, shiny side up. And now we are gonna start it. All right, and this is where you want a wider blade screwdriver, because it is a pretty big hole here. So you want something that's gonna actually reach across and not shear any of that copper off. Apparently I don't have anything that's that wide, so I'm gonna have to just make this work. And you want this to be about like the jets, you want it snug. But you don't want to break any of that apart. Actually, that may fit. Nope, still doesn't fit. All right, it does get to a point where it stops. So you gotta be careful because this is soft. So I'm gonna get this one in there. Like I said, be careful because it does shear pretty easy. All right, it's stiff and stops. All right, see? This is why you want something that reaches all the way across, because it did try to flatten out the brass pieces. Because it is soft. Alright, and I said I was gonna use the new ones. I'm gonna compare them last second. Alright, so they're the same height. The only difference is this one has a little better looking nose on it. And this is a solid instead of a spring loaded. So I'm gonna use these solid ones. Just feels weird dropping them in there like that, but. I do have some pieces over there I'm gonna need here in a second. Get this other one. And put it in there. So here is where technically you would set your float level, but I don't have the time for that. So I'm quite literally just going to be throwing it in and hope it works. All right, so you can see a spot where it has been rubbing. So you want to make sure you put that side down. And you just work this rod in there. All right, so the rod's in there. And that's bottomed out. I may have to compare it because there is a freaking level you're supposed to have it at, and that looks way too high. So I'm gonna compare it. I'm gonna take this out and compare it to the spring-loaded one and see if I have to go back with the spring-loaded. All right, so anyways, here's the difference. Here's about where you'd want it. You do take, to measure it, you take a drill bit through there, and as long as it fits in there without lifting it up, that's how you know your level's gonna be set correctly. Because once this flips over, basically you want your fuel pushing that up and shutting it off and not running past this. Any more than that, you're gonna be running way too rich and flooding out that carburetor. This would actually run a lean condition because it would cause your fuel to cut off prematurely. So your bowl would be lower and have less fuel to actually drain out of it. So this would be lean or cutting out fuel. This is about where you want it. And it'd be way richer than this. So as you can see, there is a level difference. So we're going to swap the piece back out. Now you can adjust it and like bend it down and stuff like that, but I think I'd rather just go back with what I knew worked. Make sure that spring's in there. And put this in there. All right, sometimes you do have to tap them in a little bit. Because I remember the side was a little stiffer. All right, so then just to double check them. I think this one's just a hair higher. All right, so pretty much set. All right, so here's a little more of a demonstration. Your fuel will get pumped in here, and as long as that is dropped down, it'll allow fuel to come in that little brass piece here, and as it fills up the bowl, it raises these floats and shuts off your fuel. So that's how that works. That spring does allow a little bit of play before it opens it up, so it won't automatically, like right away, start shoving fuel in there. That does kind of help as far as like driving, you know, fuel economy. It won't dump as much fuel in there, but I'm running an electric pump and it's going to be low pressure. So hopefully I don't run into an issue where that ends up having too much pressure in there. But let's go back to the main body. That's all assembled, or mostly assembled. And we're going to start putting these back in. They are real bad about these clogging up. And for the most part, I got these cleaned up. I think I still may have some clogging. But unfortunately, there's not a whole lot I can do on it. Just because, like I said, I don't have the correct tools to be doing a complete rebuild. All right, so we're going to take the gaskets out. And try not to damage them when I'm separating them. It does come with new springs for the needles here, but I really don't feel like fooling with that, and mine are working, so take this last gasket out here. All right, so you have your four main gaskets here, as well as the one that goes in here. This is actually your nozzle for your accelerator pump. So I'm going to put that on there. So pretty much got it all put back together. You gotta make sure you put those secondaries in there, because or else you will have some drivability issues, because it'd pretty much be opening, keeping the four barrels open at all times. And obviously you gotta kind of make sure you watch out for the different lengths of these, because these are some shorter ones, these are some slightly longer ones, and then you have these that are basically the same length as these ones, but they have a different size. So now we're almost to the part of putting it all back together, and gotta try to make sure we keep this in here. She likes to just randomly pop out. It does actually actuate. The way you can test this is you can take something not very aggressive. I don't want to use tire shine. I use some fuel system cleaner. We'll use that. All right, so to test out the accelerator pump, pour a little bit in there. Actually poured a little too much. And you basically just want to make sure you're getting some pump out of this. Yeah, it's all working. The reason you want to make sure you have that check ball and stuff in there is because if you don't have that check ball in there, it'll pretty much let air suck in those nozzles, and next time you go on to lay on the throttle, it'll push half air out and then fuel. So you're gonna run into a little bit of a drivability issue if you don't have that check ball in there, just on an acceleration standpoint. But let's go ahead and get everything back together and we'll be ready. One thing I was surprised didn't come with this, with some new one of these, I was really kind of hoping that it would. So I am going to try to sand these off and clean them up a little bit, just because it does have some scaly rust on there. I don't have anything to clean that very well, so I'm just basically going to have to put it back in as it was. Which, if you didn't watch the last video, it does go like that. And then you do have to kind of tap it in the rest of the way, because it is in there pretty tight. So that's in there. And that one's in there. All right, so I'm just gonna double check all the springs. These go on these afterwards. This goes in the strainer once we put that back on. Can go ahead and lay out this gasket. It does come a little bent, which is a little irritating actually. So we're gonna try to straighten up this gasket the best we can. And then kind of just do a quick layout. Make sure everything lines up, make sure it's the right gasket. It is the right gasket. And then we are going to have to disassemble this and put it on this side. So luckily that's an easy thing. So I gotta tap that one in a little bit. Not too far, I like to keep them kind of center. All right, so get the main body back up here. Move this to the back. And this is where we're gonna actually go through and kind of not really torque everything, because it doesn't have to be very tight. But you just want to make sure it's nice and snug and it's actually going to seal. That should be good. Good. Just remember, these bodies are aluminum, so you can over tighten them, and you can over tighten them very quickly. All right, so they're all tight. Now we can go ahead and flip everything over. Something I will do is I'll actually put that up there, and another thing is this piece actually goes for this right here. Doesn't make a lot of sense to me, but it is going right there. That's rain. All right, so here's where it can get a little tricky, because you do have to line up some stuff but that's also why we kind of leave. Yep, and that right there will happen. Oh, got some dirt on it. I'll wipe it off. Luckily it has an oily surface on it. It's from that cleaning there. We are going to basically line that up first. And hope everything falls together. So now we're on to these needles. You put the spring in there and of course it doesn't want to open. You want to get the cover off. I go ahead and leave them in there because it will come in handy later. All right, but you do want to flip it all around where it's not in the way of anything. And here's where it kind of can become tricky because the spring will pop out, but you'll just set it over there, flip the cover over, cover it, and then you tighten it down all the way. And you hope that you have the right size. I don't have the right size. I remember. So I'll take some pliers. And hold it down because it will come out and you don't want that. Alright, so we go on to the next side. Alright, this side I'm gonna actually let me do it that way. It's the easier way. That way you don't end up undoing a whole bunch of crap. Just kinda be careful with the thing there. You wanna make sure it kinda moves freely too. Alright, but you just put the cover back on, hold it down into its little slot, and then tighten it down. All right, so that's all tight. Here's where it gets a little tricky because I honestly don't remember where all this stuff goes. I really don't need that because it's for like if you actually use a manual clutch, it goes pretty much bolts on here. And basically gives you a cable that activates that. That'd be something in the future I'll definitely use. But for now, I'm just going to stick with the way I've been doing it, which is completely wrong, but
it's all right. Well, the GoPro died, so I've got my camera here on my phone. That's pretty much it. You're just buttoning up the last minute linkages here. Like I said, the S-curve piece that I have at work, that's what goes here.
And that's really about it. Like, you have some odds and ends linkages like this that go from, you know, here to here. But other than that, like, that's pretty much it. Just buttoning up the linkages and making sure you put everything where it goes. But since everything's already died and it is kind of a pain to do this and operate a phone at the same time, pretty much that's all you need to know anyways. But definitely stay tuned for the next one. I'm going to be putting this back on the truck if I don't already have that new carburetor by then, because like I said, next week me and my friend are going riding bikes, hopefully in the mountains. It's supposed to rain, so we may cancel our plans, but hopefully that's what we're doing, and we'll get some good footage of that because it is gorgeous out there. If you've never been, you definitely want to go. It's like I said, the Dragon or the Charlotte Hall Skyway. Definitely a nice place to kind of just rent a hotel or, you know, cabin or whatever you want. Just get away for a couple of days. Me and the wife and him and his wife are going. So the wives are going to do their own thing while we ride the Dragon, apparently, because they don't want to take the Dragon with us. But if that gets rained out, we will still be going. If not riding, we'll just be out there just enjoying time out there. But definitely stay tuned for the next episode, because it will either be that or me putting this car back on the truck and getting it running again and hopefully getting it all buttoned up, driving it to work, and going from there. But stay tuned for the next one. And if you like the content, hit that like button and subscribe for more. Subscribe for more. Have a good one.